What it do, man? What it do? We back. I'm podding. You know what I'm saying? Me and Chris just did an excellent podcast about Brandon Ingram, his probability of staying with the New Orleans Pelicans. I'm trying to feed the streets. Y'all asking me for breakdowns. I'm trying to give y'all as much, you know what I'm saying, as much as I can within a lot of time, because I'd be tired. But today, oh, hold on. Before we get into that, I'm tripping. I'm speeding. This is Men's Mental Health Month. Hey, yo, make sure you're chicken. Make sure your mental's all right, bro. We need you here. You're an important part of the fabric of this world. If you need any, you struggling with anything, bro, talk to somebody, man. Talk to somebody. Holler at your people, man. You ain't got no people, man. Holler at me. Hit me with a YouTube comment, bro. Ain't nothing, man. It's love. We're trying to promote that, man. I'm tripping. Y'all know y'all got to get a baby intro. Hold on. I'm tripping, man. I'm tripping. 1 second.
I would never take back what I did or done because I just felt like I'm living my life and I can't do it twice. So whatever I want, I'm going to get it. Whatever I need to do, if it's something I want, I'm going to get it because I can't live twice. I'm 47 now, so I don't really give a fuck about much of nothing outside my family, my kids, and
I made 47 last week. I keep telling y'all this. I feel the exact same way. Man, y'all got any new intro ideas? Holla at me, man. I'm willing to listen. Today, shout out to that boy King Qantas. B816, please do a Marcus Sasser, a breakdown of Marcus Sasser, Detroit backup point guard, very explosive, can score, and I think Detroit is willing to trade him. I am familiar with Marcus Sasser. I'm familiar with him from Houston. I know he went to the University of Houston. I know he, let's just pull the stats up because I don't remember what he did, but I know they had an excellent tournament run. He was the AAC player of the year. He was AAC all freshman. He's the two-time all AAC, NCAA all region, consensus AA. Marcus Sasser is 6'1", 190 pounds. So he played 107 games in Houston. He scored 13.6 points a game, 2.4 assists. Marcus is not much of a passer. I will repeat that. Marcus is not looking to pass the ball. He will score the basketball, though. So I got some footage of his time in Detroit, obviously, because that's where he plays right now. And this is – shout out. Who is this from? I want to give these people their credit. Shout out to Intuition Hoops. If you ain't locked in with them, lock in with them. We gonna get them a like because that's what we do as always. Please subscribe, comment, pass it to your people, man. Just tell them boys, man. Look, man, if y'all need some New Orleans Pelicans coverage, man, them boys out here working for real. But shout out to that boy King Qantas. We about to get into this highlight reel of Marcus Sasser. As always, I have not watched this tape. I don't know what's on it. I have not spent much time watching the Detroit Pistons in 2024 other than the times that they played the Pelicans or they were on national TV, which was not much. Ken Quanta says that they may be willing to trade him. I am a big fan of the Thompson twin over there. I don't know the difference. I don't know the difference between twins. I'm not blessed with that ability. But let's watch the footage as a family. So we've seen a jumper and a floater so far. I bet. Marcus can create some space, y'all. He can't create space, y'all. You gotta like that. Take the pick. Man, Maxi Kleber, if you ain't gonna step up, brother. That's a tough shot though, because it's not a midi. It's like it's in between. We had to see what Marcus shot from three. Floater. Nope. Jumper. Okay. I bet Marcus. So listen, a couple things. This is not a very long video. This video is not gonna be very long either. Marcus seems to know how to not only run a pick and roll, he knows how to intimidate the defense into, he's just taking what they're giving him. If they're going under, he's shooting a three. If they go over, you've seen him get the center. First of all, this is bad defense. The center is no hedge on the pick and roll, just letting this motherfucker go to the other side. But he is taking what they're giving him. I like them in college, so you know what I'm saying, there's that. But y'all drop a line in the comments and me tell me what y'all think. I mean, he's 6'1", so you know what I'm saying, it's only so much he gonna be able to do. But if he can live in the paint like this and shoot the three, I don't know, again, don't know what he shot from three, but we will look that up at the end of this podcast. We're just gonna get back in this video real quick. I just want to bet. All right, so people always texting me when I'm doing calling me when I'm doing these podcasts. I don't know. All right, take the good pick. That was a damn good pick. Marcus ain't got no hesitation on that jumper, boy. Reset. I like how Marcus does not stop. Marcus does not stop moving his feet. Once the ball stops, he resets. Left. And one. Should have been a foul. Oh, come here. Yo, you see how he... Yeah, Pete, man, bro. I love when guards... The threat of the pick is there. You don't even need to necessarily use it, but the threat of the pick is there. He faked that pick three times. He faked leading the guard into the pick three times. And then in and out, dribbled to an open shot. Marcus in his bag, man. Marcus is in his bag. The pass. So we've seen dribble penetration. We've seen pick and rolls. We've seen him put the ball on the floor, shoot, get a floater, get a midi. And now we just saw catch and shoot. Marcus is covering all bases here. This is a highlight package, so, you know. Midi. You can't get Marcus an inch of daylight, dog. He is going to find the crease in the defense, and he's going to shoot the leather off the – yep. You got to know who you're guarding, Caleb. Oh, he about to cook him. I don't know who 50 is, but he cooked. He ain't felt no threat. Got his shot blocked, got his rebound. Okay. Luke Cornett with the block. Floater. Yeah, I'm with you, Kent. I think we might need him. I think he has good value. I don't know the direction that Detroit is gonna go now that Trajan is the GM over there, but we don't have enough of this coming off the bench. Who knows if Willie would even play him, but He gonna do that to my dog? Not my dog, TJ. Oh, he talk. Hold on. Cuz talk to the bench. Oh, that changes everything. That changes everything. Okay. Come here, 30. Nah, I know what y'all gonna say. He can't play no defense. Pelicans has CJ McCollum and Jonas. Look at the Pelicans. Hold on. Was that CJ? Hold on. CJ got the jumper? Hold on. That wasn't Christian, huh? That was Christian. I don't know if this is necessarily Christian's fault, though, because I don't know what the fuck these boys playing. What is this? I have no idea what this is. Anyways, the Pelicans had CJ McCollum and Jonas, and they still were a top six defense. We got to stop with the buy-in. If the buy-in of Willie is a great defensive coach, then he got to get the most out of lesser players. And he has with those two guys. So, come here, Quentin Grimes. No, that's McBride, my bad. He kind of played a little. It's crazy seeing Jalen Brunson in his highlight because he kind of got a little bit of Brunson in his game. Not as polished, obviously, but I think he's 23 years old. Damn. Marcus ain't never seen a shot he don't like. I want him to pass that one. I ain't gonna lie. I think Marcus was the 25th pick in the draft. Yeah, good leg. Man, y'all, I wanted the Pelicans to sign White Dante so bad. That was a good pickup by the Knicks. They went to sleep. That was on Marcus Sasser highlight package, guys. I ain't gonna hold y'all too long. Full stop. He's a small guard. He's taller than Jose Alvarado, which is not actually saying a lot, but he's a small guard. Marcus Sasser is 6'1". He's explosive as hell, though. He's very quick. He knows how to use his, you know, his size is not a detriment offensively because he knows how to use his handle to get him in basically whatever shot he wants. You've seen middies, you've seen floaters, you've seen the three, you've seen catch and shoot. Let's go to his regular season because I don't know. I ain't seen him play. Regular season, Marcus Sasser shot 37% from three. That's 3.4 attempts. He took 243s. He made 90 of them. He played 71 games. .512 field goal attempts in general, shot 42%, which isn't great, but I mean, he's a rookie and he's a guard. So I let's see, Marcus Sasser, most threes in the game, shot me 5 threes in the game this year. I like Marcus Sasser's game. I agree. Ken, he got some upside to him. And I think that I don't know if he's available. I can't speak to that point, but I'm saying from a perspective of like the Pelicans coming back with more offense, You know what I'm saying? Yeah, sure. Is Willie going to play him? It's a whole nother question, right? Like, I can't really answer that question for you. I don't know if Willie's going to play him. Me and Christian did a video basically saying, well, I believe Brandon Ingram is coming back. I believe that the trade market for value is for market for Brandon is slim to none. And I think that the Pelicans don't want to take a loss in the trade, which has ramifications throughout the organization. Specifically, you know, we did videos about Trey starting. There's no path to him starting if Brandon's coming back. Hey, listen, and it might work out. I don't know. I don't believe that, but I don't know. Yeah. So listen, that was Marcus Sasser. Y'all got anybody else you want me to review? I don't particularly know if I like his game. I just don't know if he's going to be a good fit for the Pelicans just based off the fact that I don't think Willie is going to trust him. It's crazy because Monty played him 71 games, and that's Willie's mentor, but I don't know. Y'all got anybody else you want me to, you want film work you want me to do? You want me to watch? Me and Chris going to do one soon. Pretty soon I might have a chart. We're going to talk about athleticism, playmaking. I haven't seen any playmaking from Marcus. Marcus on the season, let's see what his assist is on the year. His assist on the year, 3.3, which is more than what he averaged in college. So, you know what I'm saying? Maybe it's just, you know, whatever. It's not a pass-first point guard. There pretty much is no pass-first point guards anymore. They're all dead. They went out with the dinosaurs. Chris Paul is the last of his kind, which doesn't really bother me. For me, if he can make that three, if he can get to his spots on the floor, you know, the Pelicans really suffering a four-quarter offense. If he can help when that breaks down and do some things individually, I take him, dog. As a Pelicans fan, I can't really be choosy because I am tired of being a loser. I really just want to win, whatever one it looks like. Shout out to Dog who said the Pelicans was a championship piece away. That kind of delusion is the kind of thing that helps me go to sleep at night knowing that I don't have. So for me, that's it. I'm out. Peace. I'll holler at y'all later. Drop a line in the comments. Tell me what you think about Marcus. Let's talk about his playmaking. Let's talk. We can get more videos if possible. That ain't no big deal, but we can talk about his playmaking, talk about his scoring. Obviously, his defense is going to be a negative. His height is a negative. But, you know, he got intangibles. So anybody else y'all want me to review the film, put it in the comments. As always, it's Men's Mental Health Month. Take care of yourself. Take care of your people. Make sure you hold those around you tight who you love. And don't fall from the wooden nickels.